this. Welcome back, children. Let us go to our grammar topic of pronouns. We have already learned that what a pronoun is. A pronoun is a word that is used instead of a noun. So now we are going to see about forms of personal pronouns. There are 7 kinds of pronouns. First is the personal pronouns. Now in this personal pronouns, first person means the person who is speaking. Now look here, this is the nominative case, singular and plural. Singular means singular means one person, and plural means more than one. So in the nominative case, for singular we use I, and for plural we use we. Now possessive means ownership. In the singular type we use my and mine, and when it is plural we use our or us. Then accusative case means what? It is the object of a verb. What is a verb? A verb is an action word. So accusative means object of a verb. In that, when it is singular we use me, when it is plural we use us. So in the form of the personal pronouns, first person is me. Again I'll repeat, first person means the person who is speaking. Understood? Now look at the board. The second person means the person spoken to. Now here also in the nominative case, what verb, what pronoun do we use? In singular form we use thou, and the plural form we use you. In the possessive case we use thy and thine, and in the plural form we use your or yours. And in accusative form we use thee for singular and we use you for plural. Now when we go to the third person pronoun, third person, see here we are having 3 genders: masculine, feminine and neuter. Masculine means boy or male, feminine means girl or female, and neuter means it is a common gender. Understood? In the third, again I'll explain, third person, masculine, feminine and neuter, these are the 3 genders. Okay? And for nominative case, for masculine we use he, feminine we use she, neuter we use it in the singular form, and in plural for all genders we use they. Understood? Now look at the second possessive one. For singular we use his, for masculine, feminine we use her or hers, neuter gender we use its, and for the plural gender we use their or theirs. Is it clear? Now look at the third one, accusative. In the singular form we use him, feminine form we use her, and in the neuter form we use it, and in plurals we use them. Is it clear, children? Now before that we are going to see it, neuter gender it, where it is used. I will tell you there are some rules for that. We will go in detail. Now we are talking about the pronoun it. In the third person we have seen there are now let us look at the pronoun it. Understood? In the third person there are masculine, feminine and neuter gender. In neuter gender we use it or its. Now let us see where the pronoun it is used. First is, it is used with things without life. Life means they are non-living things. Okay, it might be a book, it might be a chair, anything which does not have life in it. For example, here is your book, take it away. Here it is used instead of the noun book. Here is your book, take the book away. Instead of again repeating the noun book, I have used it. Understood? So it is used with things without life. Then look at the second one. It is also used with animals and human beings unless we clarify we wish to speak of them, whether it is a male or female. Animals or human beings we say, but we use it when we do not know whether it is a male or a female. For example, the child fell and broke its leg. Instead of again using "and the child broke its leg," and the child broke its leg. I have used here its. Understood? Now here we don't know whether the child is a boy or whether it is a girl. So second point, again I'll clarify, animals and human beings, when we are not clear whether it is a male or female, we use the pronoun it. Now look at the third one. To refer to some statement going before. Now look at the example. He is telling what is not true and he knows it. Here it, we do not know exactly what he is talking about, so it refers to some statement. Understood? Now look at the next point where we use it. Now in this point we see as a provisional or temporary subject before the verb to be. To be is a verb, and when we use it, when before the verb to be, when the subject follows. Now look at the example. It is easy to find fault. What is easy? It is easy. So it is a, it is followed by the subject. So here we use it. Now look at the next point. Give emphasis. Emphasis means to stress upon, to the noun or pronoun. Means we stress more or give more importance to the noun or the pronoun. We use it. It was you who began the quarrel. Now look at the next point where it is used, okay? As an indefinite nominative of impersonal verb. Understood? We use it as an indefinite nominative of impersonal verb. For example, it rains, it snows. Here we use it. Look at the second point. When we are speaking of weather or of any time, that time also we use the pronoun it. It is fine or it is 10 o'clock. Understood? So now here you have seen where we use the pronoun it. Now let us come to the second point, demonstrative pronoun. So what is a demonstrative pronoun? This, that, these and those. These are demonstrative pronouns. They point out to some specific noun and they tell you about the physical distance. May mean some object or someone, it is near us or is it far away from us, that they tell us. So demonstrate this, that, these and those are demonstrative adjectives. Are demonstrative pronouns. Want to pause, delete adjective I said.